Hello, everyone. Good morning and happy Sabbath. Let's there we go. All right. Happy Sabbath and good morning. How you doing today? All right. I want to welcome you to Streams of Life, and we're getting things under control. I can see we're slowly migrating in. I know, like I said, by the time prayer time comes, we're loaded, but one step at a time, sweet Jesus. I'm so glad. Now remember, in this stream, smash that like button, subscribe, become a part, whether you're on YouTube or Facebook. I do want to warn everyone that our website for, I can tell that the techies are busy at work. Okay, there was an update that happened, which basically ended our template usage on the website. So don't go to our website right now, but we're putting out here QR codes for gifting. Forgiving, or the snail mail in the back, the box. We'll do that at the time we normally talk about it, but I just wanted to let everyone know. If you go to our website, I've been having lots of communication, bloop, 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 saying it's not up, and I say, I know, I am so sorry. But Andy is going to get working on that thing by Sunday, and we're going to see if we can figure this thing out. But welcome to technology. It works great. Until it doesn't, right? So many of you who saw me earlier today here at church say, what's wrong with Pastor John? Yes, he's pulling his hair out, the few hairs he has, because trying to get things printed out so I can get people to be able to donate on other sites, the Adventist site rather than our website. So anyway, praise the Lord. I'm so glad you're here. We're going to have a beautiful service. We're going to have great music. And come on up for music. Let's give them a hand, and we're going to praise the Lord together, okay? And by the way, let's sing together here. All right, all right.
Happy Sabbath, everyone. So happy to see each and every one of you here this morning joining us to worship God. And we invite you to please sing loud. We don't want to be singing by ourselves. Our first song this morning is going to be I Can Only Imagine.
I can only imagine what it will be like when to my knees. surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only
Sabbath for each and everyone. Welcome to Livingstone and Sunland-Tujunga Church members and church. We come and worship on the Sabbath day. So we are welcome once again. And I came some time ago, I do the welcome and we were trying to sing a song, you know, to greet somebody. So we're going to try it today, this Sabbath. So what we do, we just stand, and the song goes like that. You say, greet somebody in Jesus' name. You know, you stand up and you greet somebody and you smile, and you just, you know, just greet people, you know, because we are on the Sabbath day and we feel happy. So, Sherry, let me try it. Those who know that song, would help me. It goes like that. You could stand up so that, you know, you could greet somebody and you could smile at them and say, you know. Okay, it goes like that. Let to free body in Jesus' name. Let us tell them that you love them in Jesus' name. Everybody smile. Jesus love you. Everybody smile. Jesus love you. Let's go again. Let us greet somebody in Jesus' name. Let us tell them that we love them in Jesus' name. Everybody smile. Jesus love you. Everybody smile. Jesus love you. You know, so that's the way we're going to try to do it most of the time, is to greet people and wish them a happy Sabbath, you know. Great. So you all get it. So next time I come and do the welcome, we'll just go ahead and just do it, stand up and greet somebody, you know, and let us feel happy. You know, this is, thank God, that this is the Sabbath day. We are alive and we are right in the sanctuary worshiping and praising God. So let us, once again, as we bow our head, and let us give God thanks and praise. Oh, great and loving Father, once again, like you, thank you, Lord, for the opportunity you have given to us to be in the sanctuary. Oh, Father, thank you for the Sabbath day. Lord, the devil has tried his best to destroy us for the week, but Lord, we have made it through another Sabbath day. Lord, we pray that, Lord, you continue to guide us and to bless us so that we continue to serve you. Help our pastor, Lord, as he continue to mold us and to draw us closer to you. Forgive us, Lord, where we have gone wrong. And Father, help each and every one of us. Save us, Lord, into your kingdom, I pray, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Our next song is going to be What a Friend We Have in Jesus. It's hymn number 499. Oh, and if you could please stand, sorry.
Yeah.
it's, like I said, it starts happening, you know, and I see there Elsie and Renato. You guys are here, huh? It's great to see you guys. I heard you're heading back to the Philippines soon. We're going to miss you. I got to drop by. What's new? But anyway, it's wonderful to see you here and everyone here. And as we slowly stream in one step at a time. So now, as I said before, trying to do the bulletin. Some of you may be accessing the bulletin. I know a few of you have come up to me with your phone saying, what's happening? It's down. Our website's down. Don't know what it is. It's something to do with updates. Welcome to the planet. So what we're going to do right now is I'm going to ask for our deacons to come down, and we're going to give you some QR codes on a sheet if you want it. Raise your hand if you want one of these. If you need the donation site, also, we'll have Algerson put up here the QR codes. One of the things about the site being down is that's the location where we get everyone through to get to the donation site. So let's go ahead and just drop them off. If everybody's good, we're good. You might want to snail mail it in at the end, but we want to make sure that you have an opportunity to give. Again, there's Living Stones and Sunland-Tujunga. You'll see here, Living Stones and then Sunland-Tujunga. And don't do the QR code that you got for the website. It's just going to give you a dead thing. So go to the one that says donate, or even better, on the back. I've got a great idea for you. On the back of it, there is, you turn it around, it goes to jot form. If you want to get baptized, that one's not down, and that's the most important one of all. So we'd love to have you a part of our community, and I'm so glad. Thank you so much to Robert and Alex. And Alex, thank you for, we're working out this. I have no idea how that song goes. I have no idea, but I'll tell you, it was cool. Everybody comes and says hi to each other. As long as online, you know, you guys are kind of the fly on the wall in the back. But hey, we'll work it out together. And maybe we'll do that every week. Drive everyone nuts. Now everyone will come even later. No, just kidding. I'm glad we're all one team and we are a family. Let's see. What is it I have to talk about today? Let me get my cheat sheet. Over here, I've got my list. First of all, let's not forget God's closet. Is there another? Do we have tomorrow something happening for sorting? It's the following week. Very good. Then the following week we'll have sorting, and then we're going to have the event coming up on the 27th, I believe. 28th, the 28th, Sunday, the 28th, is God's Closet. What time is it going to be? Like, usually it's about 12 or 1, but stay posted. We'll keep you informed of God's Closet, and we need volunteers. God's Closet, I know everybody, when I say the words God's Closet, I remember my dad. He would say, John, I didn't know God had a closet. I say, yes, he has a closet. And there's no skeletons in the closet. Anyway, there's clothing for children. So moms or dads who need clothing for their children for school or whatever, new or lightly used, clothing for their children. There are different ages. And a mom or a dad or anybody that schedules a time between the 3 or 4 hours we have, and we have an online system where they schedule and they come in for their appointment, they pick up everything, one full change of clothing, including diapers if they need it. And sometimes there's a lot of other things. And we pray for each person. If you wish to donate your time and resources, or if you wish to donate clothing. Now, I know we always are concerned about T2 and T3 sizes for girls. T2, T3 sizes. Underwear, socks, shirts, dresses, pants, very important. And these kids, and you will not believe how many people come through. And there's so many different languages. We're trying to get, you know, Cosette, you've come many times to do translation in Armenian, but then there's some speaking Farsi, and they're trying to figure it all out, you know, and there's some Spanish. There's other language groups that have come in. I'm not off the top of my head, but Korean. Korean is one of those that have come in, and we need translation sometimes. So the thing is, we're called by God to be able to reach out to people in need. And God's Closet's an incredible ministry. We're doing it on our Sunland-Tujunga campus over there. The Sunland-Tujunga campus is a good evangelistic center. And soon we're going to be having a service. And I know I've been saying that, but it's becoming more real right now. We got to start having a worship service on Sabbath afternoon, maybe about 5 or 6, for about an hour, open the doors to the community, and reach out weekly. So I'm looking forward to that. So, okay, God's Closet's coming up. If you would like to volunteer, Maria, raise your hand back there. Raise your hand. If you see Maria back there, please keep the hand flying. Talk to Maria. I know that Susan's not here this week, but we want to remember, maybe connect with Maria and she can connect you up. Also, if you call our phone number, which is, Google it, our phone number, Living Stones SDA Church. You call it. You can dial 1 for this, dial 2 for that. I think it's 2 or 3. You dial it, and you can leave a voicemail, and that will become an email to Susan Armstrong, and she can get back to you. If you want to volunteer, we'd love to have you a part. And Constantino, I'm glad you're back. You and Carissa, you guys running all over the world. I'm glad you're alive after all that. And he already put up the posters over there. Praise the Lord. And we're going to get that place up and running. So number 2, communion. The last Sabbath of this month, the last Sabbath, which is the 27th, we're going to be having our Passover communion here. You remember that last year where we had bitter herbs? Yeah, we're going to have bitter herbs again, and we're going to praise the Lord. Now, I do want to let you know something. We've been talking with our deacons and deaconesses the last time. This time, we're going to be doing something a little different. The communion's during the service, but the foot washing we're going to have in that intermediate time. Just, we'll have Sabbath school end a little early, and we'll have our foot washing time where we serve one another. We'll talk about it during the service. But we'll do that in the midst, because when we're on a live stream, it's really hard to do foot washing. Kind of odd. So we probably shouldn't do that in the middle of the live stream, but doing it right beforehand, prepping us for communion. Does that sound good? Yep. We're going to work that one out. We'll have warm water, I promise you. All right. So then, finally, a very important moment. Transfers. I'd like to ask Cynthia Nunez to come forward. Cynthia Nunez, and as Cynthia's walking forward, she's transferring in from Hollywood Church. But also, and by the way, not only if any family members want to come up with Cynthia, you can come up with her if you'd like. So there we go. Janelle's coming up, it looks like, so we're good to go. And while that's happening, while she's coming up, Ryan and Lauren Logson have been asked to transfer. Of course, as you know, Ryan is a pastor, and they have gone to not only Sylmar, but also Burbank Church. They are requesting their membership transfer to Burbank. So Ryan and Lauren will be transferring to Burbank Seventh-day Adventist Church. Is there a motion out there to accept that? Is there a second?
Second.
All right. Any discussion? Oh, never mind. All in favor, say aye. Any opposed? I'm a little opposed. Okay, but I'll let it be. We'll let them transfer out. Okay, so let's give a hand. They go to Burbank Church as well as Sylmar. And now Cynthia and Janelle, it looks like. You're coming up as the moral support, Janelle. And Cynthia is a person that came and said, Pastor John, I'm willing to help with Sabbath school and with children's ministries.
Amen.
Yes, there's an amen from behind the piano. Let's give that a hand. Okay, now, we have been really working hard to try to build up a children's ministry program. But she said, is it possible for me to help? My membership doesn't have to be here, or it has to be. And I said, you know what? We're good with this. We can work it out. And one day, Cynthia said, maybe it's good to be able to be on the board. And maybe it's good to be able to organize. So Is there a motion to accept Cynthia Nunez from the Hollywood Seventh-day Adventist Church to Living Stones? Is there a motion out there? Is there a second? All right. All in favor say amen.
Amen.
Any opposed? I'm taking pictures. All right. Welcome to the Living Stones Seventh-day Adventist Church, Cynthia. Not that you haven't been here, but we're just sealing the deal, working it out together, and that means we're going to really get you to work. And thank you for being here, Miss Janelle. And it looks like it's almost children's story time, but before the children's story, again, I want to remind you, if at the end we don't do a collection of money in this church, we do the QR code or the box in the back. Don't forget, because we're going to continue building God's ministry here, Living Stones and Sunland-Tujunga. If it's Sunland-Tujunga, just put ST on the envelope. It's time for a children's story. Let's go for it.
The Bible, 1 Corinthians 19 and 20. Chapter 6, 19 and 20. Or do you not know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit who is in you, whom you have from God, and you are not your own? For you were bought at a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. Jesus, he died for us. He came to earth. He died for us. He was resurrected, and then he went back to heaven. But when he went back to heaven, he sent the Holy Spirit to be with us. And we have that Holy Spirit living in us. So what does that mean to be a temple? A temple is like a church. A temple is also, you know, the house of God. So we have an opportunity to be almost like God for other people, Jesus. We are his temple. And we are very, very fortunate and blessed. And I was very blessed that I was raised knowing Jesus, learning about God, the stories from the Bible, praising him. But some people haven't. Some people haven't had that wonderful opportunity. And it's a blessing that we get to be Jesus to others. When they see us, we have the opportunity to show Jesus to others. Well, that's kind of hard, but what do we have to help us? Who is in us? The Holy Spirit. Now, how can we show Jesus' love to other people? How can people learn about Jesus from us? There are different ways, but one of the first things is just showing how Jesus was when he was here on earth. Being kind to people, being a friend to people, like the song says, what a friend we have in Jesus. Well, I know many of you go to school, and maybe at school you might see somebody that's sitting by themselves at the lunch table or at the playground, and you can go and sit with that child and just talk to him. Or her, getting to know her person. Maybe you might be upset at school. Maybe something happened. You get really angry. But then you ask the Holy Spirit in you. Help me. And you can trust God and, you know, put a smile on your face. And as you continue showing Jesus that way, maybe one day somebody will say to you, how come you're always happy? How come you're always helping people? How come not you're nice to the other children that no one else likes? That kid is kind of strange. And that is when you can start telling them about Jesus. That is your perfect said, oh, I love Jesus. And when you go out today, when you are at school, when you are at home, remember that you are God's temple and that you are showing Jesus' love. So let's bow our heads. Our Heavenly Father, thank you so much for Jesus, his life, and thank you for the Holy Spirit that lives in us. Please help us show your love and show the rest of the world your temple. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
So now I was reminded there is a concert, or should I say a cantata, happening at 5 in the afternoon here. You will be blessed. A tempo, Melvira Sante, as well as Christy Agdami on the piano, and the friend Sum Inspirare. We're going to have a wonderful, wonderful cantata here. At 5 o'clock, and as always, there's some, like, goodies here, some warm drinks and all that. We are going to praise God together this afternoon. I hope you can be able to make it. You know, I would say, I hear one amen. I hear one person out there. It's like, I know we Seventh-day Adventists, we talk about lay activities. Lay activities supposed to mean that the laos, the people, are doing things. But oftentimes, lay activities is going to the bed and laying down after a big potluck. You know how it goes. And so the lay activity is not about just snoring. Listen, we're going to be together, and I'm so happy. If you're able to make it, especially bring a friend, some relative, you will be blessed. I'm telling you, you will be blessed. And we will not be live streaming the event, but what we will be doing is be enjoying the love of God in song here with a powerful message. I hope to see you there, right? Champion of Love is the title of this cantata. And I'm so glad we could have it this Easter. This Easter was very early, wasn't it?
Yep.
Yeah, it was. By the way, if you didn't see the eclipse, I don't know. It's everywhere on social media. It's like there was never an eclipse ever. Man, it was all over the place. But we got some good pictures of it, wasn't it? There's some places in the midst of the country where it actually is dead center to the sun. The moon was dead center to the sun. And I'm telling you, man, it's incredible day-night mix. But Jesus is coming again. Jesus is coming again. And we look forward to seeing him. And so now, let me go ahead and pull out. Let's have a little music for the Garden of Prayer. And this reminds me, Robert has a special prayer for Jean. Prayer for Jean, for strength and faith. Strength and faith. And that's very important. So we'll remember Jean in our prayers. Also, we want to remember Billy's sister. Billy, you're here. And I thought you were going to be over there. I'm glad you're here. We're going to pray for Jebaha. Did I say it right? Jebaha. And we want to remember her in our prayers. She's in the hospital. We're going to pray for healing for her. She's right now unconscious. So we pray for her with the love of Jesus in our hearts. Also, Polly with leg pain, we ask for healing and also wisdom and the memory. Make sure we're on task. Also, we have a praise. Giselle and Giselle and Marcos. Happy anniversary, you guys. 5 years, let's give them a hand. All right. Happy anniversary. And we have two others back there. We've got Mitchell and Tiffany. They got married last Sunday over in Loma Linda. Give them a hand. We had a great time over there, and the food was amazing. All right, so anyway, so it, not just the food. You guys were amazing as well. All right, so anyway, we praise God. Also, praise God, Anna. Where is Anna? Anna's in the back. Okay, Anna and James's birthday were yesterday. Man, what an amazing thing. James just turned 18, and I have learned in my life not to say how old everyone is. But I will say that, Anna, I am so glad I got another year with you. I'm the one with the gifts, that, or should I say the presents. But we remember you guys, and Anna gave birth to James on her birthday. I think it was 7 or so in the morning when the water broke. Well, just a second, 7 or so in the morning when the water broke, that is. And we go to the hospital, and we went she was very nonchalant. Usually she's like all over it, but she was very calm. We went to the hospital, we landed there. They said, oh, nothing has happened, go back. And Anna says, I think my water broke. And then they look, oh, we gotta get you in. And that's what happened, she comes in. And then her entire birthday, she was sitting in the hospital on a bed, waiting. And by about 6:30, she says, I'm gonna be so upset if my entire birthday, I sit in a hospital and you don't come out on my birthday. You're not going to come out the next day. Well, at 8:30 or so, 8:40, something like that, James came out. And so on Anna's birthday is James's birthday, and we swap it out. So, yeah, Lenny's birthday was last Sabbath. I totally missed that. I only know when someone tells me because I'm totally out of it. Happy birthday to you, Lenny. And we so appreciate you in this church. And also, let's see, Sterwin. We want to remember Sterwin in our prayers always. And Renato and Elsie, you guys are here. I'm so glad. I know you're heading back to the Philippines, but we're going to miss you as usual. I'm so glad. Just stay strong, okay? And Maylin, of course, has a special prayer for Maylin, who's singing up here, also with Joanna up here. And I'm so glad you guys are here singing. We want to remember Auntie Ida. Yesterday, I was able to see... Thursday, I was able to see her, and we did a bit of an anointing, but Auntie Ida, we love you so much, and we ask for strength always for you. I'm glad you're here, Lydia, ready for action. I wondered if you disappeared. You're here and ready for action, so welcome back. And let's see, Maureen, we want to remember your son. We want to remember Raphael, both Maureen and Nelson. We want to remember your kid. Just for strength and healing and prayer for healing especially. So Shirley, I'm going to remember you in prayer as well. And we love you, Shirley, and we pray especially for health and that God will help your digestion as well as for patience and perseverance. And, of course, we always remember Nika, your daughter, and Gabe, your son-in-law. And, of course, we pray for Monicia as well. Raul and Noemi have Monicia and also Ernesto and Shem and all the family and the kids. Are there other prayers that have not been mentioned that are silent? Raise your hand. Okay, very good. Jesus hears, he sees, and he understands. When we pray together now, I'm going to end with the Lord's Prayer as usual, but I'll have a moment of silence for you to quietly. Say it to Jesus and him alone. He hears from the inside out. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, you've heard the requests, the praises, the difficulties, the healing, the worries. You hear them all. And Lord, we will have a moment of silence now, and you listen to each and every individual that's here that has their own quiet request to you, Lord. Yes, Lord, you listen and you're there. Thank you so much for everything you've done for us, though we sometimes do not see it. Thank you for everything you do for us continuously. And Lord, we ask that you answer these prayers. Sometimes you answer yes, sometimes you answer no, and sometimes you answer wait. We promise to wait on you, God. Lord, bring us together and make us a team, not only in this church, but in this community, Sunland-Tujunga Living Stones, as a people of God. We ask that you be our strength. Thank you, Lord. And now let's end with a prayer Jesus taught us to pray. If you wish to say it with me, please do so. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive those indebted to us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever, ever, and ever. Amen.
Please join us as we sing Amazing Grace, My Chains Are Gone.
My chains are gone.
I heard you singing out there. What? Yeah, there we go. Oh, we're alive. There we go. We're awake and ready for action. And by the way, this is the sermon that I get fired on. Because I got a bunch of Star Trek stuff up here. Any chance I get, I got to throw some kind of Star Wars, Star Trek, Indiana Jones into something. God's enterprise. In fact, let's throw that. Let's light up here. I'm kind of proud of it. There you go. Look at that. Look at that, man. You got to put the... But this is from Star Trek II, The Wrath of Khan. I know everyone's going to hate me, but the best ship ever in that one. And costuming and everything, it worked. We all have been in the car with backseat driving, haven't we? You ever heard of backseat driving? We don't know what that is. You only know about it, really, if you're married. Right? But it goes beyond generations because mothers and fathers can also do it quite well as you're driving. Sometimes grandparents. My mom, she's very good, but her foot, I can see when I'm driving, sometimes she starts doing this on the floor. You know? But it's okay because she can drive, man. She knows how to drive. Emin, I know you're going to be out here. Emin, he used to call me an Armenian driver. He said, Pastor John, you drive like an Armenian. I said, is that a compliment? Yes. That means I can thread the needle right in between. Speaking of, in Florence, we were doing that. We drove, and the Apple app gave me this thing, and I'm going here, I'm going there. And the road gets more and more narrow, and more people, and more motorcycles, and more bikes. And it's getting literally like the row here. As the car, fortunately, it was a very small car, okay? And we were all jammed in there, and we were having a great time, but it was getting more and more narrow. And I go, because I don't know if the app is really understanding what's legal or not sometimes. You know, when you see in Italy the zona, you're not supposed to be in the certain zona, but I didn't see that sign, you know, but I get nervous, you know? So we were finding a pizza place in Florence, but it was on the southern side of the river. Boy, it was getting very close. But we made it. But I didn't take a left like the map said to do because I looked at that and it was even more narrow. And I don't want to back up about a mile. You know how it is? You get into a place, and it's like, you know, now that's when everybody's hands in the car start reaching for the steering wheel. Right? I remember there was a film back in the 1960s called, it's a Mad, 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 Mad World. I don't know if you know. It was a bunch of it filmed over there at the Palisades, Pacific Palisades there, where the big W used to be, but because this trees got sick, they had to cut them down, but the bases are there still from the big W palm trees. But there was a character named Ethel Merman. The actress was named Ethel Merman. I don't remember. It was mother-in-law. And she was always reaching for that steering wheel. There was a British guy driving. He says, are we heading this way? And she's the American mother-in-law, all mouth person, right? And she's like, you're doing the wrong thing in his ear. You need to have him respect him. This is, you know, this is my car. I can let you walk along the street. And she, as she thought of something, she grabs and slams his back and pulls the wheel, and the whole car does one of these wild things. And the whole thing from then on, the wheel's doing, you're going to wreck my machine. My friends, that's usually the kind of flight or driving that we think of as human beings because we're used to more of the, we take charge. Sometimes we think a church is like that, where the church, you have a steering wheel, and it's one person doing all of it. But the Bible is a little different than the way we think about it. We all like to be like Han Solo, just grab the stick and go, and we have a co-pilot, Chewie, that helps out. We all like to just do things. You don't need other people to do them. And in fact, we see this in church and in the world all the time, where one person just, I'm going to do it. It's me. Everyone, leave me alone. Don't touch me. I'm going to do it. And there are certain things that work like that. But to grow a church of God, there is some text that Paul writes for us. In fact, let me make sure I get the right location. There it is. Take a look here. See if it focuses in. It's kind of hard. See that language there? Let's see. See that? It's ancient Greek. It's not Klingon. Paul writes how the church is to work in Corinthians chapter 12. Turn with me in your Bibles if you have them. You can raise them up. I have my Bible here, but I promise you I'm not going to read in Greek. But it's 1 Corinthians chapter 12. Verse 12 we're going to get to, but let's take a look. Let me grab my Bible over here. And as I grab my Bible, like I said before, we all import the way we think about things onto how God does things. And we see this all through history, where someone will say, I think it's a good idea. You know, in the Dark Ages we had this. If you'll remember, the Holy Roman Empire needed money to build St. Peter's Cathedral. So a Medici, Pope Leo, he thought it was a great idea to do indulgences, which was to tell people that if they give a certain amount of money, then they'll get to heaven. And then John Tetzel comes along and says, oh, I've got it. He was a salesman and half this guy. The minute you hear the coin hit the bottom, the soul of your beloved relative that is in hell will spring to bliss. That was a very good idea business-wise. And it raised some money for the church. The only problem is it was wrong. Dead wrong. It told people that God cared about gold. Is this a man of God or a man of gold? Is the question. Gold is good. God created it, just like he created people. The only difference is he died for people. He didn't die for silver and gold and diamonds. His blood was spilled for human beings. So sometimes we think we're right about something, and then we find out we're dead wrong. Let's see how God's church works. And then we're going to get, I promise you, did you see the Enterprise over here? We're going to get to the Enterprise and Captain Kirk and Captain Terrell and Spock. We'll get to them very soon. But you have to understand why. So Paul says, chapter 12, 1 Corinthians, chapter 12, verse 12, just as a body, though one has many parts, but all its many parts form one what? Now, you may not want to look at my body, but here it is. There's 2 feet, 2 ears, hopefully, 2 eyes, 1 nose, 2 nostrils, 1 mouth. Thank God for that. Right? You know, some hair. 1 head. One head. Okay? I was told, I had a theology teacher that was talking about church leadership. And there was someone talking about how, well, this person's in charge, but that person, there's always the thing. And Roland Hill said, John, anything with 2 heads is a monster. I agree. Well, maybe that makes sense for Revelation, the 7-headed creature, right? It's like, that tells you how largely disorganized it is, because everybody's got their own agendas, and sometimes in God's church, we're all grabbing our own set of steering wheels, pulling our direction, instead of working, what? Together. But if you work together, here's the problem. That means there's someone that's in charge. What if you don't like that person? Oh, you know, even we as a country have experienced this one, right? We're experiencing it right now, and we experienced it earlier, and I have a feeling after the next election we're going to experience it again. There's going to be people, someone that a lot of people don't like, another one that a lot of people don't like. Unity is very difficult. So we want to be hands-on ourselves. Can we just be in charge? Forget all this. I'm going to just do it. Totalitarian always works for us when we don't get what we want. But here's the problem with totalitarianism. It doesn't work. Let's read what God says. So we have many parts, but one body. So it is with Christ. Verse 13. For we were all baptized by what?
One Spirit.
One Spirit. Look at this. One Spirit. So as to form one body. Whether Jews or Gentiles. Ooh, that's a big one. Jews or Gentiles. This is one thing I love about Star Trek and Star Wars, for that matter. I mean, the actual good Star Wars back in the past, where you had like this different kinds of creatures, different kinds of people, different kinds of shapes, different kinds of colors. In fact, Star Trek was something else back in the 60s with this. I remember Uhura. Remember, anyone know who Uhura was in it? She was a black lady. And she had the fro going, man. And she was the communications officer. And there were some, in a time of massive racism, there were people that were very upset. But Gene Roddenberry stayed on because he says, this is based on abilities. It's funny because Uhura, near the end of her first season and going back in, she was really thinking about the actress who played her, I don't remember her name. She said, maybe I shouldn't do it anymore. So she was thinking about not accepting the second season. Martin Luther King Jr. wrote her a letter and said, your appearance on that TV show changes so much for all of us. She was like, she hadn't thought of it that way. She was thinking of it more like, man, it's hard. And then Sulu, in a time when the Japanese were not popular among many, after World War II, Sulu is there on the phasers. How do you like that? All these different types of people. Well, even we've got a guy named Spock here, right? With the ears looking kind of like, well, we could say if you like Lord of the Rings, you could say he looks like an elf. But I want to say Klingon, but he's not. He's my brain damage. Vulcan, thank you very much, Sherry. You got it. A Vulcan, logic-centered person, but yet he's half human, half Vulcan. Do you see what's going on in the story? Different people can work together. You don't have to have things exactly the way you want them. You can't have things, or should not have things, exactly only the way you think is best. There are many parts of the body. Different parts have different perspectives. The foot is a heck of a lot different than the eye. In fact, he says that. Let's read. Are you all with me in this? God has called us to be different and work together. The right says we all need to be the same. I mean, generally, I'm talking about historically. The left says we need to have everyone working together, but it's become like, okay, everything is the same also. So it seems like both sides are saying the same thing. Somewhere in the middle, you got to find us working together. God died not just for white people or black people or pink people or polka dot people but he died for everyone. And he calls everyone to be a part of his enterprise. God has a great work to be done. You know what an enterprise is? It's a work. It's a work to be done. And that's why the enterprise was named the Enterprise. For its job was to go to uncharted worlds, to seek out new life forms, to go boldly where no one has gone before. Remember that? God's church is called to seek out. Keep your finger here. I'd like you to turn in Acts. Another A one. Acts. Actually, not Acts. Let's go to Matthew chapter 28. It's even better there. Matthew 28. We're going to have a thing called the Great What? You know what that is? The Great What? Commission. It's the very end of the book of Matthew. It says, all Jesus says to the disciples before leaving, all authority in heaven and earth has been given me. Therefore, go and make what? Disciples. What? Disciples. Bring people into our thinking process so that we can work together. A disciple, didaskolos in Greek, of how many nations? All nations. That's why I like to say every color, and I sometimes start throwing in purple and green, because it's beyond just us. Every language barrier can be broken because we are brothers and sisters in Jesus who died for all of us, right? And that includes even ages. You know that? It's interesting. I won't go off there, but it includes ages as well. All nations, baptizing them in the name of the what? Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Teaching them to obey everything I commanded you, and surely I will be with you always, even to the end of the age. In the call to prayer, just last Tuesday, I was referring to Indiana Jones, who's like, basically, Paul is like the Indiana Jones of the Bible. He went way out there. He kept going, searching for people, and he went through everything. He went through shipwrecks, multiple shipwrecks. He even got bitten by a venomous serpent. He shook it off, and everybody was worried he was going to die, and he didn't die. And they said, man, you must be a god. He says, oh, no. I'm not a god, but I know a god. Boom, the entire island starts to know about God. How do you like that? Seeking out new life forms, not the serpent, but the people. Going boldly, even to Rome, even though it brought on certain death for him. Let's go back to the book of Corinthians. Verse 14, even so, the body is not made up of one part, but of many. In other words, we're working together, right? We all work together. Now, if the foot should say, because I'm not the hand, I do not belong to the body, would it for that reason stop to be in the body? Yeah, if the foot, imagine, I got a good hand, I don't need a foot. Let's take the foot off. What? Right? That doesn't work, right? Unless there's a problem with the foot. If there's like an infection that has not been dealt with and it starts to die on its own, that's the only time you take the foot off or the leg off. But that's different. God wants the foot, even though the whole point of the foot is to stomp or walk, to be walked on. Now, if you did that with your hands, would you be able to draw? That would be hard. If you're always using your hands for your feet, that wouldn't work. Imagine using your eyeball for walking. It's like, I mean, come on. Think about it. We'll all roll. It doesn't work, right? Imagine using your ear to pick things up. Now, there are those who are paraplegics that have to do that. You know, in the wheelchair where you only, all you got is this, and so you can kind of, you can draw. There's people that are, with technology, there's people who have really overcome barriers. But that took many people working together in an enterprise to make sure that that person can do something in their life. I'd like to now show you a little bit here. The enterprise, interestingly enough, it's very, very different from the others, like a car. You know, this ship is supposed to be very good. Now, a person inside the ship is very, very, very small. In fact, the bridge is right here. See that little area right there? Inside there is a place that looks like this down here, where all these people, including, let's go ahead and get that camera down there, Captain Kirk right there. And the reason why you're looking at him from the back is because this is the window, or should I say the display, of which they can see, where they can see anywhere that has a camera on it. But I want you to notice there is one character right here. His name is, at least in the original, it's Captain James T. Kirk. Captain Kirk needs to know how everyone kind of does their job, but he doesn't do their job. You know that? He sits down in the captain's chair, and along with his first mate, here's Captain Kirk, along with his first mate named Spock, work together to make decisions. It kind of is like piloting a submarine. Submarine has this, where there's a captain, a first mate, and an XO. And these three kind of work together, and they make decisions, and sometimes they disagree. But they keep the disagreement among themselves so that they can have a ship that is strong with everyone working together. Now let's go to some other characters on here. We have Captain Terrell. He was from Star Trek II. We have Captain Terrell standing here. We also have now right here is Uhura. This is from the 2009 version. Uhura is here. We've got Chekhov right over, I believe. Oh, no. Yeah, Chekhov is right here. And now Chekhov deals with propulsion, right? And then we've got Sulu that deals with defenses, shields, because if you're under attack, you have to make sure you're safe. You know, a church is much like that. You know, we have people that defend the church. You know that? If there's a problem, deacons oftentimes are the all-in-wonders in the church, and deaconesses, but especially deacons in defense of a group of people. It's kind of like how elephants work. When a predator comes into the area of where elephants are, you know what happens? The babies go to the middle and the adults all surround them. Defense, automatic, shields are up, right? My friends, our church and God's work needs to work like a bridge of God's enterprise. We love to take control instead of allowing ourselves to work as a team. Now, here's the hard part. Sometimes you get in a situation where Captain Kirk has to do a lot of things. And the reason why he has to do a lot of things is maybe someone's sick here. And they're down at sick bay. And that guy, what's his name, the doctor, I forget his name, McCoy, is taking care of him, or the guy's in the medical. Or maybe Spock is out and he has to deal with that. Or maybe communications with Uhura. Or something else is happening. So therefore, because of emergency, Kirk has to deal with other stuff. But there's always a secondary and a third option for someone to come in and start to be a part of the team. But the biggest problem is, in the enterprise, is when you have someone like Khan entering. Khan was a guy that tried to create a mutiny and get everyone on his side and take over the ship, instead of working together with everyone. Our church is the same way. You know that. The Apostle Paul in the Bible, he starts, you know, going with the differences of different parts and how just because someone's a foot, you don't look down at them. They may be a little stinkier than the eye, but they're purposeful, because they are able to do the grunt work there. The arm is of utmost importance, even though it can't see. The brain is important, and that should be Christ. The eyes need to be those who can see the horizon of what's happening in the community and say, Pastor, should we be able to change this or that? Elders are nervous systems, kind of like the Scotty part sometimes, dealing with the engines and making sure that the ship works correctly. It's operational, so that the captain can actually get something done. Does that make sense? We work together, and this is what Paul is saying. This is the reason why the Christian church that should not have grown, it was a Jewish organization after the resurrection of Jesus, and the apostles, the 11 apostles, were busy at work trying to make sure that Judaism, including Jesus, was going to work. And there was persecution from the temple. That was the temple, the leadership in the temple didn't want these Christians around. And it was ostracizing oftentimes from Judaism, from the religion, which it wasn't supposed to be like that. Jesus and the temple were one, but the only problem is the leaders of the temple didn't care about Jesus, and that's the problem. But what Saul did when he was called to be Paul is he said, maybe I'm being called for the Gentiles to go outside the walls of my own people, to reach out into the world. And those who were uncomfortable with that, they were not happy. They don't belong here in our church. See, we've heard that before, haven't we? But Paul followed Jesus, going boldly where no one had gone before, reaching out. And because of this difficulty and this separation, what he did was enable new people to organize themselves around the Spirit and the one baptism, which brings them together. Are you with me? I know there's one of those that's like, Pastor John, I know you just like popular culture and things like that, but let me have an answer for that. Popular culture oftentimes has within it breadcrumbs that God ordained since the beginning of time. Maybe we can pull those things out and realize that God's word isn't so far-fetched. Maybe, just maybe, us trying to separate from God's word is the problem. As you get to know how God runs things, you start to discover that the real you can be you for the first time ever. Verse 21, the eye cannot say to the hand, this is in, again, 1 Corinthians 12. Verse 21, the eye cannot say, oh, let me move backward for a second. 17, if the whole body were an eye, where would the sense of hearing be? If the whole body were an ear, where would the sense of smell be? But in fact, verse 18, and read this carefully, but in fact, God has placed the parts of the body, every one of them, just as he wanted them to, what? Oh, have you ever thought that the reason why you're here is that God called you to be a part of this kingdom, of this enterprise? You ever thought about that? My friends, I can't do the work of James T. Kirk if I don't have you taking positions that are of importance to get things done. Are you with me? We all must work together. That doesn't mean everyone's a captain. I mean, come on. Not everyone's a captain, but then not everyone's a medical. But then not everyone's communications. But then not every. See, this is how we work. We work together. And you will find frustration as you work together on the bridge of God's enterprise. You'll find frustration. Oh, you will. Because there will be cons out there. There will be manebulas out there. There will be Klingons out there that will attack God's church. I mean, I'm being symbolic, right? I know there's no Klingons out there. I understand that. But there is a devil, and he doesn't like the church to happen. He does come. I want to tell you that even though you will find difficulties working with others for God, you will also find the camaraderie and a blessing that you will never be able to shake when you know your brothers and sisters, no matter what color, what language origin, what kindred, what people, doesn't matter, because we're all brothers and sisters because of the mission that God has given you and I in our hearts. My call to you, and I need this. I'm being very serious right now. I just said I'm calling you, and it's Living Stones Church. I am calling you. All right, very good. Don't forget the cantata this afternoon. All right, I am calling you. Okay, can I have everyone's attention again? That's it. I am calling you to be a part of the kingdom of heaven, God's enterprise.
I'm going to ask you to please stand as we sing our last song for today, Awesome God, Humble Thyself.
Father in heaven, we thank you for this beautiful illustration from the Bible. about the different parts of one body that will contribute to the wholeness of the church. We pray that we will recognize and know that you are the captain, that trusts us to form one body, recognizing that each one of us is equal in the sight of God, even though you all have different contributions. We thank you for all the powerful messages from the Bible, the truths that we can learn from it, which are as relevant today as it was yesterday. And may we all have a blessed rest of the Sabbath. And we thank you for the opportunity to worship you and to study your word and to sing praise songs to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Thank you so much, Charles. And don't forget, we've got food there in the back. And especially don't forget, Champion of Love. At what time? 5 o'clock, you got the phone call. I called you. Since we had children's story, I went over a little bit. So, but we're good. Anyway, praise the Lord. May God bless you all. I'll see you tonight if you're there, or if not, on Tuesday for call to prayer. Have a wonderful Sabbath.